Good morning, class. Today we are back again with the new topic of meiosis 1. We were discussing meiosis 1, in which we said in the previous video that this is a kind of cell division in which we will half the number of chromosomes in the daughter cells. So we discussed with the interphase 1, in which we said that there will be a G1 phase, after that there will be synthesis phase, after that there will be G2 phase, and these whole phases were called as the interphase. After that, as you people all know, that a cell go through with mitotic phase. So right now we are discussing the mitotic phase of that cell, in which the first phase is called the prophase, because we are discussing meiosis 1, so that's why I have written here prophase 1. And in prophase 1, I said to you people in the previous video that this prophase is different from the prophase of the meiosis, in which there aren't any kind of the five phases which we discussed in the previous videos, as leptotene, the first phase in which you people saw that the chromatin is condensed into the chromonema. In the second phase, which was called as zygotene, in that we saw that chromonema are more condensed into the chromatids, as you can see over here. So this is the structure which we saw in the second phase of the prophase 1, was called zygotene, in which we said that we will have a bivalent structure of the two chromosomes. I repeat here again, this is chromosome number 1 and this is chromosome number 2. In zygotene, your chromosomes, they are now in the form of the chromatids. There will be an intimate attachment of the two centromeres and the arms of the two chromosomes. So this is called an intimate attachment of this whole pair. Now we are here and we will discuss the third phase of the prophase 1. This is called the pachyteen. In this stage, or in this phase, the sister chromatids, they are distinguishable. I mean, you will condense, a cell will condense its thread-like material more, because the prophase is all about of condensing chromatin into finally chromosomes. So as condensing is going on, so in the third phase there is also condensing, and by the cause of condensing or by condensing, this here you cannot see any kind of sister chromatids. There are sister chromatids of these two chromatids, but they are not in condensed form, so for that reason they are not visible during the zygote. But in this phase, in pachyteen, you will observe the four arms, as you can see here. Okay, these were the two arms of the two chromosomes. Now there are four arms, means in that phase you will observe the sister chromatids of the two chromosomes. So this is how you will have a structure called the tetrad, means the four arms. As you can see, the four Q arms over here, and these are called the four P arms. So the conversion from the two arms, into the four arms, forming a tetrad, is known as the third stage, called pachyteen. I repeat, in this stage, your sister chromatids, which are not visible in the second phase called zygote, now they are distinguishable clearly see that the four arms, they are now of the two chromosomes, as we have named these as chromosome number 1 and chromosome number 2. So this is called the appearance of the sister chromatids, or a phase in which sister chromatids, they can be distinguished from one another and forming a structure called tetrad, means the four arms is called tetrad, and formation of these this tetrad will occur in this phase called the peccine T. So this is it. So the new phase called the fourth phase of the prophase 1, it is called the diplotene. You can call this phase as an important because of this reason. In this phase distinguishes the prophase of mitosis and the prophase of meiosis. So in this phase, the non-sister chromatids, as you know, these both are called the non-sister chromatids. These both are called the sister chromatids, but these both are called the non-sister chromatids. So in this phase called diplotene, the non-sister chromatids, they exchange their arms with one and other, and this event is called as crossing over. I repeat, crossing over is an event which occurs during the diplotene. It means that the non-sister chromatids, you can see over here as well, that these two are the non-sister chromatids of chromosome number 1 and chromosome number 2. So you can clearly see that this chromatid is now intermingled with this chromatid, and this chromatid is intermingled with this chromatid. So these both are together called the non-sister chromatids, and the region, or sorry, the process by which they change their genetic material, it means the genes. So this process is called the crossing over, and this occurs during this phase called the diplotene. The point by which the two non-sister chromatids are attached with one another, that region you can call as chi strata. You can see this region, this is called chi strata, and this region it is also called the chi strata, means the region of the two non-sister chromatids by which they are attached with one and other, and by this chi strata they exchange their genetic material with one and other. So this happens during the phase called diplotene, and this is called a key difference between the mitosis and meiosis, because in mitosis the homologous chromosome, they also come closer to each other, but as I said, they do not form a bivalent. They do not form a bivalent like this. This was the first difference I told you in the previous video, that there are so many differences between mitosis and meiosis. The chromosome number, they become half. This is a kind of difference. The number of daughter cells are different in the mitosis and meiosis, but these are not the genuine differences. Okay, the bivalent, it forms during meiosis, but it do not form during mitosis. Homologous chromosomes, they come closer to one another, but they are not intimately attached with one another in the prophase of meiosis, but they are intimately attached with one another and they form a bivalent. So this happened in the second phase of the prophase 1 called the zygote. Now during diplotene, a process which is called crossing over, this causes the major difference between mitosis and meiosis. Okay, during mitosis, these two non-sister chromatids, they do not exchange their their arms with one another. So this is how the sexually reproducing living organisms, they cause a kind of a variation. This is more explained in the next chapter as well, and inshallah we will discuss over there as well. So I repeat again that during diploidy, the non-sister chromatids, they exchange their genetic material, the DNA, between one another. So the genes, they may exchange between the two non-sister chromatids, and this is how the variation comes in the living organisms. They are not completely different from their parents, but they are somehow different from their parents, because the daughter cells, which are going to be produced by the end of this meiosis, they will have a certain different genetic material. I'll also explain this whole in a kind of figure as well. So this is called the diploidy. Let's move to the figure. I know okay, this is not very much clear, so let's make it clear again. So as you can see, okay, this is called chromosome number 1, this is called chromosome number 2. These two are the capital A's because they both are the sister chromatids, and you know okay, the concept of sister chromatid is that okay, whatsoever there will be a gene, there will be an exact copy of the gene. So this is called the sequence of chromosome number 1. Okay, it possesses capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D and capital E. This will be exactly the same as these both are the sister chromatids. This is called chromosome number 2, in which you can see okay, there is a gene A but in a different form. I repeat, there is the gene A. There isn't any kind of difference in the gene, but the difference is of the sequence in the nucleotides. That's why this is written in the small letter. But the genes are the same, because homologous chromosomes are so called in that sense that the both the gene will have the same location on the two chromosomes. So this is what called the small a, the small b, the small c. The next copy or a different copy of the same gene. So this is called the chromosome number 1 and chromosome number 2 before crossing over. But during the diploidy, this and this will be called as the non-sister chromatids. I repeat, these both are called the sister chromatids, and these both are called the non-sister chromatids. So the event of crossing over will occur between the two non-sister chromatids. This is not necessary that these both arms will get exchanged. There may be exchange of only gene A. There may be exchange of gene A and B as well, or there may be exchange of the whole of the arm. So in the next process, after crossing over, you are looking that this possess the same sequence, because this wasn't exchanged. But after crossing over, the chromatid of chromosome number 1 is now changed. So this is how you can say that whatsoever will be the sequence of the parent DNA, the parent chromosome, it will have a kind of a different sequence, and this sequence of different genetic information comes after the process called crossing over. So this is called the process which happens during meiosis, and this causes the variation in the living organisms, and that's how they are kind of different from their parents, and they are not exactly behaving like their parents. because of this reason ke in the meiosis there is an exchange of the genes between the two non-sister chromatids. So this happens during the diploidy, but they both are not separated from one another. I mean, there is still a bivalent. For your better understanding, I draw these two chromosomes separately, but still remember that the bivalent is still in contact. Still bivalent is that is in contact, and in the diploidy we saw that the exchange of the genetic material it occurred between the two non-sister chromatids. So this is called the diploidy. Now let's move to the next stage. So the last phase of the prophase 1 is called the diagenesis. As we are discussing that there are three things that will be done in the prophase, called the condensing of the chromatin into the chromosomes, which we saw this happened in the first phase, leptotene. This also happened in the second phase called the zygotene. This also happened in the third phase called pachytene, and this also happened in the fourth phase called the fourth phase called the diploidy. Now the two things they are still left for the prophase, and that is called the disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus. It will occur in this phase called the diagenesis, and also the third thing of the prophase, that is called the formation of spindle fibers. This also occurs in this last phase of prophase 1 called diagenesis. An important thing that will also occur, and this is called the terminalization, means what we formed before this structure, I mean the intimate association of the two chromosomes and the non-sister chromatids. Now in that phase, diagenesis, the bond, or people were calling this as the synapses. Synapses will break, and this will cause the breaking of called the separation of these two centromeres from one another. So in that case, they will separate from one another, and they will exactly form a shape which we saw in the meiosis. I mean, by the end of prophase of meiosis, what structure we will have, we will exactly have the same structure in by the end of prophase 1. They will be called the breakage of the bivalent, and these two chromosomes will just slightly separate from one another. They will not separate at much extent, but they will separate just for a little, and you can also call this is called the breakage of the bivalent, called terminalization. Now we have exchanged, I mean this was happening in the previous phase called the diploidy. Now this is called the diagenesis, in which there will only be the terminalization, means the breakage of the bivalent, the disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus, and called the formation of spindle fibers. So this is called the end of the prophase 1. In the next video, we will discuss about the metaphase 1 and the telophase 1 and the anaphase 1. So this is about today. I hope you have understood all these things. If not, then please let me know through your feedback.